those who have done a comic for a long time, I want you to put yourself in these shoes right now for a quick second. You're an auspicious person looking to kickstart a new comic, fresh idea, brand new, and you just do it. You just start. Episode one, boom, public, out into the open. But next week you gotta publish some more. And then some more after that week, because you've already made a schedule for your devoted fans who are waiting. Do you see the point of this premise here? Salutations, and welcome to the Aviv channel. If you're new here, hello, welcome. My name's Aviv C. Call me either that, either or. And if you're coming back, hello, welcome. I always enjoy you coming back. I appreciate you always showing me support on not only my videos, but any other things that I have in the work. So, today's topic, of course, is what you've clicked on to, and you want to see what the hell are we getting into when we're talking about going with our comic work without a buffer. Because who in the right mind would trudge through chapter one, episode one, and then keep going at it every week, working to the bone without a proper buffer set up? And for those who don't know what a buffer is or what we're talking about today, well, that's what I'm going to go ahead and dispel to you all and explain what it is and why some people really, really encourage it, and maybe why you should encourage it if you're looking into doing comic work for yourself. So as you can tell from the length of this video, it's going to be probably a lengthy one. We'll see. If you got nothing to do, find something to do. If you don't have nothing to do still, that's the cue. You need something to do still. So go ahead, draw something, cook something, clean something, sew something, paint something, do nail art. Show me that on Twitter or Instagram. Go ahead and tag me and tell me that you listened to this while you were doing something productive with your time. Without further ado, we're going to go ahead and you're going to nab a pencil pen or cooking utensil or a margarita, if you're of age. And let's dive. The topic at hand is buffers, buildups, or some people call them archives, like I do. You may wonder, what is a buffer? Well, a buffer is just comic artist's way of calling backup or backlog of the comics that they work on for a period of time before they set it out to the public, and they just let it build up, you know, over time, and then they start publishing it with a good schedule at hand. It's just to make sure that people don't work to the bone every week, like with that example, AKA me, and just keep pumping out a comic like every day or so, or, you know, just to have something at hand, like a pack of cards, poker cards, you know, a deck of cards, and they just pull it out and then boom, just throw it at you. They have it ready to go. So it's like a pre-made inventory. Okay, we could say like inventory. And this is not cheating in any sort of way. I don't know why that would arise within someone, and someone would kind of go into this this argument that, well, you know what, that's not authentic, or, you know what, that's just cheating the system. I don't even know what arguments could stem off of this, because I haven't heard any good ones. And if you have a good one, go ahead and throw it at me in the comments. I like a good banter every now and again. But so far, only good things happen from this. So I think it's something that you should probably really look into. And maybe I'll try to convince you over to this side of understanding. But for those who are a little stubborn in their ways, I got you. Well, now that we know what a buffer is, let's go ahead and discuss who uses buffers. Surmising that anybody, any sort of way, could use a buffer, the amateur to the professional, all within the realm of anything that you think is a creative medium, they use buffers. Believe me, when you're writing chapters for a book, there's buffers there. There's chapter buffers. Sometimes they do spin-off stories even, like whole spin-off stories, just to put something out there so they can gain an attrition or attraction to get people in to read the story and, you know, get the money. And while they're still working on their main serialization. Another medium that probably uses buffers, of course, is, you know, the typical TV show. Granted, they still have to get that stuff out. But if you think about it in a long spectrum sort of way, think about it like this. They don't go into the studio every week and film an episode. They build it up like for a season. And then once the season's out, they work on the next season while that season's playing. That way they don't have to grind to get their actors together, or somebody falls sick and they find a replacement. They don't do that. In fact, that wouldn't be smart, would it? Can you imagine having the actors coming in every week to get that favorite series that you watch every week, like a soap opera, and they have to like come together and churn in whatever is happening in their life just to get that episode out? No, that'd be too messy. And if there is something that operates like that, I would call call that a art project, because I just don't find that smart, and it shouldn't be.
As you can tell, every circumstantial pieces of works, content, or anything that people put their time, money, and attention to will be pre-recorded or recorded beforehand, so it could go through the studio, so it could go through editing, so it could go through processing to make sure everything is tip-top to be shape. It doesn't go up there in a spur of a dime, not usually. Again, there are exceptions where they'll do it for artsy purposes and expression purposes, but usually in a production, business, professional setting, they will do it beforehand in advance. And those who publish mangas, they do buffers. My understanding, there are several examples of them doing art buffers. I could go ahead and put them up on the screen. Those that I know that do buffers on the top of my head are people who get their mangas serialized. You know, they actually draw the sketches of the chapters before they actually go into the line work, detail work. So they consider that a bare minimum finish. Actually, there is a mangaka artist I can think of on the top of my head because I've seen him do it. I watch him on YouTube sometimes because he goes live with his manga chapters. His name is Yoshikairu. He is the author of Tsukumono. It is an anime that premiered of April the 2nd, 2017, with a manga serializing in 2007. So when I watch his videos, sometimes I see him go through his chapters and he'll start sketching out each of the plot points that are supposed to happen in stick figures. And so it's kind of entertaining to watch because it's a well-known author not only showing his progress, but also showing that he actually does buffers. He doesn't just on the spur of the moment make the chapters on spot because he knows that he has to get these serialized and published and pumped out and get money. So he starts to sketch these figures and he starts to plan the story, and it's a whole, you know, plan backlog going on. Not necessarily a backlog, but it still has the same concept because he is not on the spur of the moment just getting stuff out there. So it's not putting in the spiffy details or spiffy posh details. Now they just get the sketching done, and then it's considered kind of done, and they move on to the next sketch or next chapter sketches that they need to do, and that creates a backlog of sketches that are chapters, if this is making sense. Just because the chapters look like skeletons and stick figures and stick balls does not mean that it is not finished for a manga artist, especially manga artists. But for us webtoon artists, it looks a little different, because once we put our work out there, we have our time's not as malleable as the mangaka artists, because they are their time is, I want to call it infinite, but people know, looking at that detail that they do, it has to take a lot of time, and people are expecting, you know, for them to have their space and all the needed time and no pressure to get the chapter out, and people pay for it. So they expect, you know, good quality. But for webtoons, since webtoons are free, firstly free to read if you got internet, and secondly, since we don't have editors or we don't have someone bearing down our backs, which, do mind you, having an editor is a good thing because they not only see the problems with our works, but they get to correct any sort of things that we have not seen while in production mode, and they get to advise what would be the best move market strategy wise. So having an editor is good.
People should not expect you to be pumping out a chapter every week with no pay sometimes, with no editors, with no endorsements, with no publications, with no advertisements to get these chapters out. And you could tell by the tone of my voice that people still do. And it is not a pleasant experience when you run into these hooligans who think they can harass you for saying, oh, well, this should have been out weeks ago. This is so short. Look at the detail in this. This is pathetic. And it's like, you better. If there was only little bit of time that I had to deal with you and your squabble that you're bringing up, I would really plunder it to you. I would really hammer it down for you. Because to explain it very concisely, we do not get paid by Webtoon. And if we are not a Tapas exclusive, we do not get paid by Tapas. We're not paid by either of them unless we're an original or exclusive. It doesn't happen. We don't have that. Now, there are other sources of mediums where people will be more lenient on you, like Patreon. People support you on Patreon because they actually like you. They like what you do. They're fans and stans. They're basically stans of you. And that's something that people like because they are understanding people. So back to the topic at hand, veering will not be strong in this one. Buffers are used by everyone. Everyone understands why they use them because they are extremely helpful and there is no cheating behind it. There's no weird stigma. There shouldn't be a stigma attached to it. And you should just do it because think about how the real world operates, like the examples I gave, and just it's just the way to go. This is now the question. Should we do a buffer? Should you do a buffer? Now that I've told you everything, what it is, who does it, and why it's important, consider this for yourself. Should you do a buffer? Well, in one of my videos, actually, that video that I privated, I 100% still stand by what I said, but I'll play it up right here. So you want to go ahead and create a backlog, yeah? But I don't encourage that. Not for your first one, no. Especially if you're doing a casual comic. Because, listen to me, heart to heart, if you start making a buffer and then you start uploading the actual comic and people start liking it and, you know, you're working on your most current episodes and you look back at your first episode because, you know, it's your buffer, it was from way back then, maybe like months ago, your art's gonna look a hell of a lot different because you're improving, you're changing, and you're not going to be satisfied unless you're just an always satisfied person, a pessimist to pessimist if you are, and just generally knowing how human nature is myself, I think we both understand that you're not going to like it because that's what's just going to happen, unfortunately, unless your art just hasn't changed at all whatsoever, you haven't learned any shortcuts all the months of working with it. You're going to be disappointed with your first episode, and that's fine. That's part of making errors, making mistakes, and with creating a backlog, it's like a pick and choose for me. That's why I don't encourage it. I actually say go at it, go for it, just pave your way. And this is probably not good advice, but it helps you a whole lot to just be in the moment, to just hurry up and go, go, go. If you don't have a backlog, if you're all doing this just verbatim, you know, cold turkey, just doing it. And that may not be good advice, but it's if you want to learn faster, I recommend don't do a backlog. Just do it. Especially if you've been sitting on these ideas for years, just go for it. Just do it.
Yeah. And to a certain degree, I still believe that. Let me explain why. The reason why I encourage people not to do a buffer, the reason why, sole reason why, is because those people who won't do a buffer are the people that don't understand why they need a buffer. And it takes that first time experience for them to go ahead and feel the fire. Now, am I one of those cruel believers who believes in, well, you know what, you gotta go through the depths of hell just to feel it too, and you gotta do what I did back in my day, kid, and this is just how it is, the shit is hardcore, and you gotta learn to live with it. No. I do it because I want to not give it as a learning lesson or teaching lesson or anything like that, but I want people to find their flow. I want people to find their flow because there's a problem that arises when people start listening to other people so closely that they don't start listening to their own voices. Now, look at here. What website are you on? You're on YouTube. You're here to listen. But I am talking about people who don't really seem to have a steer, coordinate sense of purpose and following their own voices. At times, some people are abysmally bad about listening to their own voices. Oh, wait, I think I'm talking about me. But anyway, what I'm trying to say is people don't listen to their voices. I'm trying to let them have a voice. You listen to you as you do you. But come what may, I know people are very influenced and they'll listen to every word that you say. People should be able to experience the need. Ah, there it is. Experience a need to have a buffer. Not a why you should have a buffer, or not because Janet told you to have a buffer, but because you need it. I want people to feel that need, that
the drought of aid that you wish to replenish your soul with. I want people to feel that need without having to be drowned out by a marmalade of different opinions and options and voices coming into their sphere of what they need to do. Of course, again, you're a human, you're supposed to delegate that, come as you will, you're in charge of what you listen to, what you do, but I want to make it a little more flexible, a clean palette, if you will, so you don't have to expect much out of what you probably want to be doing. And that is why, because also, when a need comes away, and with away becomes optimization, people will become more creative with how they do their buffers. They'll become more like finding shortcuts for buffers, and we need more people like that who can discover these shortcuts, discover these different ways of how to make the buffers easier, simpler, and now faster. That's part of the reason why I'd encourage people don't do a buffer, because I'm inadvertently trying to get them to do a buffer. Yeah, that's what I'm doing. Now, as I said in the video, I probably it's probably not good advice, but the reason why I say it like that again is because I want people to go ahead and find the trouble of why they don't have a buffer and what happens when they don't have a buffer, and then they'll come to the notion, oh, well, you know what, I need a buffer. And you know why? Because they didn't listen and they learned to make a buffer. They learned to be efficient. And so I want to kind of kickstart a little growth in some people, kind of kick them awake. I want to kick some people a lot, like, wake up, make these decisions on your own, do this for yourself, because you are the conductor of your own project, and I shouldn't have to be the one to tell you you need a backlog, because this is going to hammer you down a few seconds. I know you're a passionate baby, you want to get out there and you want to do it, but you're going to see when you do it, and you didn't listen, you said, fuck them, I'm doing whatever, you're gonna see that you're actually gonna get fucked, and it's gonna be ruined, and you're not gonna have a good time. Now, to denote something of a recent trend that I have been witnessing myself, some people will go ahead and take some months off to go ahead and build up the buffer. I know some Webtoon originals do it themselves because they have to, hence because they get something out every week, it is part of their schedule, and they say, well, now I'm going on vacation and I'm going to not draw for 3 months, and then for the rest of the months I'm gonna go ahead and build up that buffer because they have to, because it's a series. Like a series, like a TV show, like seasons, they have to build up a buffer so that they can go ahead and put it out, and then when the next season plays, the next season series plays, they go ahead and play out the next episodes. So this is not uncommon as well, but you don't want to be the person to take so many hiatus where you hardly get the story out. Wow, this video is really hitting home somewhere. So, do you think I have the right to speak like this? Yes, I do, because I have experience. Guess what, guys? Ding ding. I was that person who didn't listen to a lick of advice that people told me about doing a buffer. I jumped into it. Psychophant example. Clap it up. Yeah, didn't have a buffer. Doesn't have a buffer. And I guess I'm still going. There you have it. That's the reason why I said that in my previous video, and it sloppy sort of manner, too long, didn't understand. Basically, I want people to figure out for themselves, and they'll see what the hell really waits for when you don't have a buffer. And I'm not being a Schweinfurt. I'm just being somebody who wants to see change. And when change comes about, when challenge comes about change, there we go. When challenge comes about change. And yes. With that all still said, I still encourage you to go ahead and make a buffer. Go ahead and do that buffer. Even if you don't want to, even if you're not convinced, even if you're not hearing us out, the people that encourage it, still go ahead and make a buffer. I would still stand by saying, advising the people, make a buffer, make a buffer. Go make a buffer, please. But I won't force it down your throat. I won't. At some point, I'm going to be like, okay, just go do it. Go do it. Just go do it. Go at it. And yeah, that'll just be the end of that. Now, there is another example, an exception to why I also say don't do a buffer. They're the people who, again, are stubborn. And also on the other side, the people who sat on those ideas for years. I'm talking to those people, the people who they didn't go for it. And I want people to just have that go get 'em attitude. I want that fire to be reinvigorated. So with those kind of people, those are also the people I say, okay, just don't do a buffer, just do it. And when you just do it, you'll feel the fire, you'll feel the flame, especially if you still have a love for that passion, for that idea. You want to see the world come alive, take flourishment. You're going to be that person who's going to be like, okay, I'm feeling it again. I'm feeling the youth that was in this story and that is waking me, and I'm going to go ahead and do it. And that is something I always like to hear as well. Now, the problem arises when they'll come into combatants with themselves and they'll come into a corner and things will get tough. It will get hella hard. Because not only did you sit on these ideas for so long, not only that, but you don't have the buffer, you don't have the backlog, you don't have the plans, you don't have the details. Shit, 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 shit. It's going down in flames. Because you're internalizing and you're starting to beat yourself up that this is a problem of you. And the reason why you can't get it out as fast is because not only because you're busy and you have other obligations to attend to, and there are obvious reasons why you can't because you're human, but you internalize it anyway and say it's a you problem, but really when it's not. And so that's kind of why you also shouldn't tread in the territory of jumping to get a buffer, because it can be detrimental to your mental health, and it will be detrimental if you are not a self-sustenant person and you have a problem with insecurities or down talk, when you have a problem with down talking yourself. So again, that is a summary of why I recommend to, or those are the exceptions rather, of when I tell you don't do a buffer. The people who are stubborn and the people who sat on the ideas for years. Because in the outturn of the people who sat on it for years, they'll either keep going or they'll make another project because they were, you know, re-inspired to do something, or they might give up altogether. That's just the reality of that. Whether or not my soul actions or any soul actions or anything of the soul actions of this world, the factors that are, whatever they may be, that it may not be the only proponents that push someone towards their ultimate decision, because at the end of the day, you are responsible for yourself and you. I think that's all for today. There wasn't really much to go over with the buffer story, but I just, again, to refresh and remind, go ahead and Viv's seal of approval, make a buffer, do it, go for it. And to those who are stubborn, who aren't convinced by this video or any other advice, and to those who sat on the ideas for years and years and years, for those people, go for it. Dive in, just do it and see what we mean. And if you do greater, you could go back and tell me that, I was wrong. Yeah, you can go ahead and do that. But for now, I think that will be the wrap up of this video. And for the next video, I think it will be out maybe soon. I'm not sure. And if not, it will probably be an announcement video, because everyone, I am having my launch of Monarch very soon. And I'm excited to get that out there. Now, did Viv have a backlog for this one? Oh, hell yes, I did. So look out for that. Keep your eyes peeled for that. If you have any other sort of questions or topics you would like me to discuss, go over, or skim over, go ahead and pitch it to me and I'll give it a swing. If you got anybody you want to recommend to me, like maybe other YouTubers to collab with, I'm open for collabing with people. That's fine. And get what some of their experiences of making webtoons are like. And, is there anything else? Oh, right. And go ahead and eat those chocolate eggs, drink the chocolate milk, drink the eggnog, or do whatever you do for Easter or whatever holiday you may celebrate. I'm wishing you all a good one, as always. All right, I'll leave it off here.